It's here, the new Fluke 1670 multifunction testers. Fluke claims these testers can cut your reporting and documenting time by up to 50%. We'll see. Many electricians and electrical contractors report spending up to 25% of their time on data management and reporting. We're joined by Jit Patel, Fluke's product manager, to find out how Fluke took on customer feedback to design their Fluke 1670 series multifunction testers so that this time is decreased by up to 50%. We're going to find out how Fluke have achieved this and how they have improved their Fluke Connect feature on the 1670 series. As only field time tends to be included in customer quotations, electricians are constantly looking for ways to decrease pre-assessment time. How does the Fluke 1670 series help with this?
Well, you find that a lot of the times when electricians are trying to get all the metadata together, they're writing it down on a piece of paper. Mm-hmm. A lot of that time, it's information that they either know beforehand or only know once they go on site. So collecting this information, typically it's not we're putting it straight into a PC or in a report, they're writing it down. So there's a lot of double entry that's going on. And collecting this data, sometimes you miss things. So what we've done, obviously, with this tester is the ability to actually set up all of those circuits whilst you're on site, but then also take that data and actually assign it to those circuits. And then also, because we've got it in what we call a form format, you're able to see quite easily whether you've done the measurements or whether you've got any measurements missing. So you're collecting three different, you're covering three different pain points. One is missing tests, one is collecting that metadata, and thirdly, you're making sure that they've all passed, and you're not going back to the office and finding out something failed later on.
If you want to read more about each of the 1670 series multifunction testers' reporting capabilities, remember you can click the links in the description, and do remember to look out for our videos on their testing capabilities. So another widely reported problem is that of double entry, so recording results on a piece of paper and then entering them into a certificate later.
Sure.
How has the Fluke 1670 series been designed to help with this?
Right. So double entry, just so that everyone, we're all on the same page, double entry is where you're writing on a piece of paper, you're getting all that information, then later on you're returning to the office and typing it all into software, or you're writing out.
Yeah.
Neater. So basically, you're doing it twice, so you're spending 50% of your time on that. So the way we actually do that is allowing the customer to actually do that on site. Well, maybe I say in two ways, either on site or beforehand, because sometimes you do have that information beforehand. And if you have that information beforehand, the easiest way would be to use the true test software, put all that information in, and this is where this comes into its own. You'd be able to send that data up to the instrument. So it's a bi-directional instrument, so you can send information up to the instrument, but also transfer it back again.
How would you do that, via Bluetooth, via USB?
So at launch, it'll be via the USB, and then later on, we'll add the Bluetooth. But the data's pretty quickly, you transfer it either to or from the true test software, which allows you to then print out your reports in the model form format. So the double entry comes from having to do that manually. So obviously, if you're collecting all this information on site, then you're able to download it to the true test software and then print off your results.
Saves time.
Absolutely. 50% of the time, as we've been saying.
So professionals also reveal the preference for saving results on the tester itself. How has Fluke incorporated this feedback into the 1670s design?
So we've actually pushed the bar out when it comes to actually collecting that data. It's actually, we've almost revolutionized the way you actually do it. Much in the way that, our customers are using mobile phones to enter data, you've got the same thing here, almost like a smart device. So once you've actually entered all that information, you actually get on here a format where it looks almost like a form. So this is the distribution board. And then if I go into the distribution board itself, then I actually have all my circuits here as well. So what that actually means is that I can work through all the report, or I should say the test results sheet, going into each individual cell. Once I go into a cell, basically I can press the test button. It will then go into the measurement, I perform the measurement, press save, and it will drop the measurement into that table. Now, the beauty of that is that it's very visual, and you can see all your tests and your test results in one place. But also, if a cell's missing data, it could be that it's meant to be missing that data, but I'm aware that it's missing that data. Which was another thing that a lot of our customers told us in our interviews, is that they'd get back to site, start actually putting the information into their computer, they realize they missed a test or something failed which shouldn't have failed. You know, we spoke to an electrician yesterday and he even said, oh, you know, you get to that point and you might even make up that measurement because you're so embarrassed to go back to customer site. So alleviates that type of issue that you may come across. So the other thing I just mentioned is the fact that something could fail. So once you've actually set up all the metadata, if you do that on site, so you don't have to do that, but you can set up the circuits themselves. But if you set up all that metadata, so like the overcurrent protection device, the type of RCD, it can work out your limits for you, for your maximum ZS value. Once you do the measurement, if it fails, it will show you in red that it's a failure, or it'll show you in green that it's passed. So very easy visual cues telling you whether something's passed or failed so that you won't miss it on site.
So you can enter data onto the 1670 series. Can you also create reports on them?
On the instrument itself, you can't actually create the report.
Okay.
The true test software is where you would create the report. There's a lot more report than just the test results themselves.
Yeah.
So we need to give them the ability to do that. What we're looking to do in the future is probably transfer some of that into maybe the Fluke Connect software. So this is an ongoing project that we're going to have here, where we're just going to carry on adding features for our customers to make it easier for them to, you know, enter that data, collect that data on site and generate reports.
And every time you do update the sort of software like that, will the customers must be able to take advantage of that? Will they be able to download it and update there?
Absolutely. So with the TrueTest software, you know, as it's a, you know, the desktop software, that will be automatic updates that you get. Then also with the Fluke Connect software, it's an app, so it will update itself. As far as the instrument's concerned, there will be, you know, constant updates or I wouldn't say constant updates, but updates that we will obviously put onto the Fluke website, which you can then download, put on a USB-C stick, and then just enter it in the instrument and it will update the unit.
And is it just Fluke Connect and the Fluke TrueTest software that it's compatible with, or can it be used with third party applications or anything like that?
Yeah, so, you know, where it would be the most powerfulest will be with the TrueTest software, because you've got this bi-directional data.
Yeah.
What you will be able to do is transfer the data to the Fluke Connect software and then email that file to yourself. What you do with that file then is up to you. But obviously, if you want to do the bi-directional, if you want to get the full capabilities out with it, of it, then the TrueTest software would be the way to move.
So can I clarify, are all these features available on all the models in the 1670 series?
That's right, yes. I mean, you know, through all of our interviews, we realized that, you know, documenting data entry was really important to our customers. So we didn't want to force you into going up to higher models if you didn't need all those features. So you can document, you know, by sending data up to it or transferring data down the bi-directional, entering that all on site in the instrument itself. The only one caveat to that is obviously with the 1672, it doesn't have Bluetooth, it doesn't have Fluke Connect capability, so it won't have that compatibility with Fluke Connect, but you'd still have that compatibility with TrueTest.
And we're going to move on to talk about Fluke Connect in a minute, so if you want to find out more information about the 1672, please do click the link in the description or look out for our videos on the 1670 series testing capabilities. Now, your customer research found that some customers had some issues with the Fluke Connect feature. How has this been addressed for the 1670 series?
Okay, so that's a really good question. I mean, one of the things about Fluke Connect, when it was designed, I suppose, it was a lot around our multimeters, our clamp meters, and also our TI cameras, for example. So very asset driven. So not so much what we would call like, you know, circuit or structure driven. So when you transfer data with our current 1660 series, it's like single shot measurements. So different from a typical workflow of an electrician. So it wasn't that, customers had a problem with it. It was just more that they wanted something that would follow their workflow better.
Yeah.
So what the principle here is obviously the data that's taken out on here, you can actually transfer it to Fluke Connect, and then you can email that on to the office, for example, where someone could finish off that report for you, and then email that even quicker to your customer. But then also, as we move along with Fluke Connect, we're going to carry on adding extra features to it to make it simpler for the customer to be able to generate reports, be able to, get all that metadata, take images, all those sort of things that you would get, typically when you're creating or editing or even, collecting data on the site.
So you mentioned taking images. Can you currently take images and tag them to your circuit? Is that a capability that's available now?
So that's going to be something that we will bring later on, and we expect that to be pretty quickly. Right now, you can use Fluke Connect to take your images and save them directly in there. But one of the things that we hear, from our customers is that, yes, they typically, if they find a fault on site or, a cracked luminaire or something that they want to show the customer, they take a picture. Once they've taken that picture, they then have to go back to the office, resize it, put it on a report, etc. So the intention really is that within Fluke Connect, you have all those images and you're able to generate your report from that. And so as we move on with the software, everything's going to carry on improving over time. We'll include those features within Fluke Connect.
Yes, it's future looking.
Absolutely, yes.
And so are there any other features, reporting or otherwise, that you'd like to draw our attention to?
Yeah, I mean, I suppose the main thing really here is the bi-directional, being able to collect data and be able to transfer it both ways. But take, for example, you go back to a site after 3 or 4 years, to do your periodic inspection. You already have that information within TrimTest. Therefore, you've got your circuit structure and you have all that information on there. So the idea really is as simple as, after the first year where you've done that testing, you've got that information within TrueTest, and you can then, when you go back, upload that information back into your test instrument. And whilst on site, you can check that nothing's changed. We haven't added any circuits, nothing's changed from that. But also it means that I don't have to spend the time to set it all up again. It's all in the instrument. I can then make my measurements. I can save them or tag them to that particular circuit. Save all that, transfer it back to the TrueTest software, and be able to generate my reports a lot quicker the second time.
Great. Thank you, Jess. And that was very helpful.
You're welcome, Jess.
Thank you. Remember to check out those links to the 1672, 1673, and 1674, and look out for future videos on this topic. We'll catch you next time.